Light me up, light me up now, baby. Yes, Grow Me, the DJ, and Lukas will sing Light Me Up for Poland at Eurovision 2018. Should we talk about it?
Let's do this!
Now, do y'all know that show, Ibiza Weekender?
Yes, I do.
It's, you know, it's really trashy. People at the hotel, in the sun, doing naughty things. This song has a very Magaluf Weekender, Ibiza Weekender vibe. It's totally disposable, generic, and I feel like I've heard it before. And that's why I love it. That is why I love it. This is feel-good fun. In this year, in any year, you want some songs that you can just hum along and love. You know, outside of a message. Yes, there is a message about living your life, making things happen, all of that, I get it. But I like that this song is easy. Easy songs become radio hits. I love the pairing here of, you know, the lead singer who looks like he stumbled out of a tattoo bar, you know, meeting what appears to be Moby's long-lost cousin who's a librarian. There's so much about this that shouldn't work, and that's why it's so wonderful. I didn't like it initially in our first review video.
Yeah.
I was lukewarm. But the more I hear it, the more I like it. I think it's going straight to the final. This is in the second semifinal, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm not sure.
Yeah. It's going straight to the final. There's no way this is not. I think it's feel good. It does have a contemporary vibe, actually. And it's got the Polish diaspora. It's all positive from me.
I have grown to like it more, I would say. It is a grower more than it is a shower. I do think I am maybe a little off put by Grow Me being that the focus was so much on him in the Polish national final staging. It kind of took away because the whole idea, fair enough, he's there and he's the name, but Lukas deserved his moment. And I feel like the connection is going to be more with him than it is with Grow Me. I actually think he looks like, what was that guy that did all the taxidermy specials on? Like Channel 4 in like the noughties. He has the same hat. I think that I just kind of feel like it's a bit not dated in like a long dated sense. It feels like a David Guetta song from sort of the late part of the noughties to the early part of this decade. Like it kind of, a lot of the ones he did with Kelly Rowland, like Commander, When Love Takes Over.
When Love Takes Over.
That Commander is just beyond epic.
Oh, it's such an amazing song.
Such an amazing song. But it has that kind of sound, which is why I kind of feel like I've heard it before, but it's not to the point where I'm like, this is completely wrong for Eurovision now. Mm. It's okay, it's just about within like a good boundary. Lukas sounds very good. I think that they will massively improve this by the time they get to Lisbon, because they were operating on such a tiny stage, like it felt like they could just fall into the crowd at any point. And you know, the Polish staging, everything that they've done recently at Eurovision has really done well, and they've amped up from where they were in the national final. So I have good expectations for this one. I'm more enthused about this than I have for any Polish song since 2014.
I think Poland this year was a very weak field, wasn't it? It was a really weak field of songs, and Light Me Up didn't particularly even stand out in that weak field. Congratulations on getting the Eurovision ticket. This is actually quite decent, but you know, it's funny, like the whole Light Me Up, Light Me Up, that's the pre-chorus. The chorus actually doesn't even have any vocals. It's just an instrumental mishmash. And it throws me off a bit. It really throws me off. I think the hook is quite hard to find, but there is a familiarity to this. There is a Dirty Weekend of feel to it.
We went from Magaluf Weekender to flat out Dirty Weekender.
I mean, yeah. So, and it's got that Balearic sound to it. So it's okay. It's okay. In terms of qualification, I think it's borderline at best. I don't think it's dead certain.
Certain.
No, I think you're only saying that because you feel that the Polish diaspora will carry it up.
No.
But
I'm more confident about this than I was about Kaja Moss based on the song. And she's my girl. I love her. But I'm saying that one I was worried about. This I'm not worried about.
Well, at least Kaja Moss had a message. You know, there was a whole... You know, rightfully so, animal rights concern would light me up. It's about...
You know, songs don't have to be about animal rights to be good. I don't feel like an EDM song has to be preaching anything. It's just about having fun and living your life, and that's coming through. Look, my score is a 7.5. I think they're going to the final. I think this is fun. I love Grome, the DJ, how he's just like... He's hilarious. He's like wacky and he's like, you know, just doing his thing. Like, hey, I'm dad,
the
barbecue.
Moby librarian.
The Moby librarian. He's hilarious. He's very attractive. I don't mean that as an insult. I love the glasses, the specs. He's got specs appeal. I can't wait to meet you, Chesh.
And I do think it will qualify. It's in the second half of the second semi final. It's got, I was just checking then, it's got songs like Montenegro. It's got like Georgia. The only one that will cause a problem for this, I think, is Slovenia, because that has the same thing where it has like the instrumental chorus or the tune chorus, and I prefer Slovenia. But I'm giving this a 6, which I think is higher than I've scored most of the Polish songs recently. But it is, I enjoy it. I don't dislike it when it comes on. I will listen to it all the way through. I don't think it's going to be one that I will listen to forever after Eurovision. I think this is very much a Eurovision 2018 and then it's done one for me. But that's not a bad thing. I think it will qualify. I think it will do well. I think it might end up on the left-hand side of the scoreboard, but lower down. But no, I think it's another safe, good pair of hands for Poland.
What was your score?
Oh, it was a 6. Sorry, I don't know. Yeah, it's a 6 for me.
My score is a 5. I think this is a safe entry. I think it's a decent entry, but it doesn't leap out of the box. And I think that songs need to bring a little more to the pop table. That said, it's a 5. It's not appalling by any means.
Well, that's what we think. Before I say that.
The Wee Wee bloggers, ranging from 18 to 80, all the way from Austria and Australia to New Zealand.
All over the place. It's not very far from New Zealand, Australia, is it? They're all over the place. In any case, the average score of all these people when we light up the scoreboard is... 6.36. So
that's okay. I mean, when you're pushing nearly getting to 6.5 region, that's sort of like
I think anything above a 5 is decent. I really do think.
So you
that.
Think all the songs are decent then? Because I don't. There are very few that dip below a 5.
I haven't ranked all my songs. You see, I don't know how people rank because I haven't ranked all my songs above a 5.
Well, just scrolling through this, only like 2 or 3 songs get below a 5. So in any case,
spoiler alert.
That's what we think. What do you think? Are Lukas and Moby look-alike, Gromy lighting it up for you? Let us know here on WeWe Blogs.
Be sure to follow our journey to Lisbon, and you can do that by actually subscribing, because when you do, you'll get a nice ping alert telling you of our upcoming videos as and when they're released.
Some do you know the word concise? Do you know what concise means? And you have to subscribe to notifications to get the bell every time.
Absolutely.
Hit the bell to get the subscription every time. Light us up in the comment section below.
Yes! We'll see you later.
Bye!